advance on the existing literary analysis. So what, have you added to a discussion, or have you created a space where a discussion hasn't existed previously?
I think more of an addition. There's definitely work done on Lady Macbeth, and there's some stuff done on her political importance within the play itself, but from what I found, there really wasn't any discussion on her political importance according to the historical backdrop of Shakespeare's lifetime. So I think that's definitely what's new about this project, is that there's really nothing done with her. There has been done a lot with Macbeth and the male characters in the play, which is how I based a lot of my analysis on Lady Macbeth.
So in some ways, your work is a parallel between Lady Macbeth to previous literary work that's been done on the male characters.
Yeah, although surprisingly, there wasn't a whole lot out there about the Elizabethan succession crisis and how it might have influenced this play. There was stuff about succession in King James, not nearly as much about Elizabeth as I would have expected, considering the fact that he had written under Elizabeth for so many years before this play was written.
So I think the most compelling idea and single line in the thesis is on 53, where you talk about Lady Macbeth's contempt for dynasty, quote unquote. I think that's a very powerful idea, and it makes me wonder if we approached it backwards. In other words, we talked about succession, which is an element of dynasty, but the concept of dynasty is itself worth thinking about. And going to Andrew's comment about Elizabeth displayed contempt for dynasty in not marrying, although that's wrapped up also with her sex and female rulership, the problems inherent in that, I suppose. But in not appointing a successor, at least, if you're not going to generate from an heir of a body, you could at least designate one. And so, this idea of contempt for dynasty is a way to sort of talk about what Dr. Ayer's talking about here in terms of thinking of Lady Macbeth as an Elizabeth character or a comment. Elizabeth, the world having changed now that she's gone. Of course, this assumes that it was written after her death, which is, there's still some conversation about when this play was written. But this idea of contempt for dynasty is really kind of intriguing, because if you approach the problem from that angle, it makes the threat against her own child even more powerful, in the sense that the child is dynasty. I mean, if Macbeth is going to be king and he has a child, and it's never identified whose child it is, if it's hers. Like in history, of course, the child does exist, and it's hers from a previous marriage. So it's a stepchild, not Macbeth's. But that's not clear at all in the play. And I'm not sure if that was in general known. But anyway, this idea of contempt for dynasty is really interesting, because it makes her threat even more powerful. It extinguish any potential line that would descend from, potentially from Macbeth. I wonder what you think about the concept of dynasty. If we set aside the whole notion of succession, which we've been pounding at, and we think of just the concept of dynasty instead, just on your feet here, can you think of how that might alter in a way your theses? Do you have more than one thesis?
Yeah, well, I think it would definitely be more narrow dynasty. Are you talking about like dynasty as like kind of an offshoot, like a type of succession, or are you talking about dynasty just in general, like establishing familial lines, like blood lines? Okay. I think it would definitely alter the thesis, because I'd have to go more narrow. As we talked previously, I'd have to look at the actual historical Macbeth, Lady Macbeth, which was actually, that was an idea I was just tossing around the beginning of this. I definitely have to go more into those genealogies and try. I would definitely just look at those and compare those to Lady Macbeth instead of more general ideological political discourse that was going on at the time.
On the same topic, there's a really interesting point that keeps grabbing my attention. What trumps dynasty? I'll tell you what trumps dynasty. Macbeth's oath is what trumps dynasty. I would, while it was smiling in my face, have plucked my nipple from his boneless gums and dashed his brains out, had I so sworn as you have done this. And I can't remember what Macbeth's oath is. So I look back through the play, I can't find it. There is no oath. Where did he swear an oath? I can't find it. I have looked very rapidly, but what trumps dynasty is this non-existent oath. So there's something in there.
Behind the scenes.
There's more to dig here.
Yeah.
As Rose was saying, and I think the whole thesis could have been pages 52 to 5.
But yeah, that is the heart of it.
You can understand that because you actually say that on 53. You actually say that he's more important than Lady Macbeth or Macbeth, right? So you understand that, but it's as if you came to it a little late. But he didn't. I know that he didn't. But it could have been recast to explore just those few lines, as indeed. Hamlet in Purgatory talks just about the four or five scenes and the two lines of text of the ghost, right? The fact that there isn't a whole lot of material doesn't mean we can't dig it.
Yeah, I see what you mean by dynasty instead of succession then. Because that probably would have
in a way, this question
opened up the idea of the son a lot more than just succession.
It might be in that, but I don't know.
Are there other questions before we devolve into?
Yes.
I think to go off of Dr. Martin's question, do you believe that her bastardry would affect her feelings towards dynasty? Because if it were her, she would rather focus on succession, not dynasty.
Wait, are you talking about Elizabeth?
So, Elizabeth, yes.
Okay.
Because do you think that the feelings were more towards succession rather than dynasty because she was appointed with the succession?
Well, I think Queen Elizabeth wasn't really concerned with either succession or dynasty. She was concerned with her rule at that time. She knew she didn't want to get married because she didn't want to transfer power. She also was worried. She was worried about her advisors and council. And what they would think about if a foreign ruler came in, like a foreign king. She was also worried about causing internal conflict within her advisors. And she also was worried about the idea that if she were to appoint a successor during her reign, that there would be different factions that would gather around this successor instead of her. So she wanted all of the support and focus to be on her. So she wasn't concerned with succession at all, or dynasty for that matter, so. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Rachel.
Krista!